first time you felt the speed, or the first time you heard the engines roar, the first time you saw the green flag wave, and the excitement of the checkered. Were you on your feet when someone became your hero? Did you hold your breath when you first saw the smoke? And did you cringe when the tires screeched? For the NASCAR fans and family, these first times are a long time gone. But today, NASCAR celebrates a new beginning. Today, we honor everything we've loved about NASCAR from the first moment until this moment. Welcome to the grand opening of the NASCAR Hall of Fame.
Charlotte, the Queen City of the South. NASCAR was born here. NASCAR belongs here. 61 years of dreams and determination meet their destiny today with the opening of this sport's very own Hall of Fame. Welcome to Uptown Charlotte, where today, May 11th, 2010, will loom as a tremendously important day in the past, present, and the future of our sport.
Good morning, ladies and gentlemen. I'm Winston Kelly, the executive director here at the NASCAR Hall of Fame, and it is my privilege to welcome you to our grand opening ceremony. It was over 5 years ago when the Charlotte region launched our bid to become the home of the NASCAR Hall of Fame. Since then, literally hundreds of people worked on the effort that led to Charlotte being chosen as the home to the NASCAR Hall of Fame, and thousands more have worked to build this incredible facility.
When the search began for a location for the hall, Charlotte would emerge as a most appropriate choice.
Happy to tell you today, the NASCAR Hall of Fame is going to be right here in Charlotte, North Carolina.
On January 25th, 2007, ground was broken for the new facility. On the southern edge of Uptown Charlotte, North Carolina, a glistening, state-of-the-art facility rose into the Carolina sky, destined to become the largest and most technologically advanced sports Hall of Fame in the world. Meanwhile, the 25 nominees for the inaugural class were announced, a group that included drivers, car owners, and executives from little-known red clay pioneers to household names. A panel of 50 voters met behind closed doors, and the first five NASCAR Hall of Famers were announced. Richard Petty, the King. Dale Earnhardt, the Intimidator. Junior Johnson, once hailed as the last American hero. Bill France Sr., the founder of NASCAR. And his son, Bill France Jr., who nurtured stock car racing from a regional institution into a global phenomenon. The search started for artifacts, and they started arriving from throughout the United States. And now, through tireless efforts, finally, such a place exists. Welcome to the NASCAR Hall of Fame.
What a proud day it is for all of us in NASCAR. If you grew up loving the sport like I have, and you idolize all these guys sitting behind us, and you wanted to get an autograph like the one I got with Richard Petty back when I was, I don't know, I must have been 25, Richard, because we were close to the age, but seriously, in Martinsville, I got a chance to get my first autograph with Richard, and Rex White was my favorite driver. And so, to be able to be part of that today and see this building, it's just unbelievable.
Look, as you heard today from many people who helped put this together, NASCAR's a team sport. It takes an A-team to do something big and do something special. And that's what you have behind me and out there is the A-team that has brought the NASCAR Hall of Fame here to Charlotte. I want to tell our fans, you have the best Hall of Fame in the world right here in Charlotte. Thank you.
Here's the king.
You know, just to see NASCAR grow to what it is today and to see them finally have a Hall of Fame and then to be inducted into it on top of that. Of all the thousands and thousands of people it took to get NASCAR where it is today, we just went along for the ride.
For me to go in the first bunch with Richard and Francis and Earnhardt was just unbelievable. I could not, it still ain't soaked in. It's when you got that kind of company in a process of doing a Hall of Fame thing, you just cannot explain it. It's just the greatest thing ever happened to me.
5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
The thrill of walking in this place with all these, I mean, my hero, Junior Johnson, right here in front of me, Richard Petty and the Francis. It's just an amazing day. Patrice Earnhardt back here and looking around and we're in. It's open. It's here. It's real. It's big. I love it.
You can't rain on this parade, Larry.